Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Zia Park here on Wednesday. It is November the 27th, 2019. I'm going to look at the stakes races on the program, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. I mean around the world. But let's get to the stakes action today from Zia. The card was great when they drew the races last Wednesday, but with the virus going around by Remington, the shippers had the scratch, so it went down a little bit. So it's not, you know, it's still a good card, but it could have been a little bit better. Well, we'll look at all the stakes races, races 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So those are races 3, and then races 5 through 10. Did you get that? I hope you did. Let's get to the third race from Zia, which is the Zia Park Distaff. It's going for a purse of $100,000, race for fillies, mares, 3-year-olds, and upwards. We have 6 horses going to the main track, but we'll probably be down to a field of 5 at least, if not 4 horses going the distance of ground of 1,200 meters or 6 furlongs on the main track. 1,200 meters, 6 furlongs, and I show the diagram. It just gives me that little extra second to look down, Minoch, just bear with me. Top selection, we're going to go to the rail to the one horse cash checked or charge. I'm going to go 1623 in the superfecta. 1623 super. Top selection. One horse cash check or charge. 3-year-old filly by Will Take Charge. Case Lambert trains. Isaiah Enriquez gets the leg up. The horse's most recent outing came 20th of October in Zia. 6 furlongs in the Chavez County Stakes. And the horse won by a length that day. He stalked early on. He got the lead. And then he just took off clear. That was a very good run. Before then, in his Zia debut, 6 furlongs in the lounge race, 35,000, non-3L. He won by 3.5 lengths. And I thought that race was actually a little bit more impressive than the race afterwards. Again, he only had 3 of the rivals, but he just took off clear. That was a very good run there, and could have won probably by more, but, you know, it just... you just didn't want to kill a horse there. And then before that, at Albuquerque on the 14th of August, 6 furlongs in a lounge race, non-2L. He won by 6.5 lengths there. And again, he could have won around another 5 times and won that easy. 40 cents a dollar he was supposed to win. Just keep in mind, last time out, he was 11-1 where he won easily also. You know, you haven't gotten to the bottom of this horse since his debut at Albuquerque, where he just didn't have the best of runs. And he kind of, he just needed the race for experience. He's been doing everything right recently. He's been training well. 5-2, I think he's very likely winner. If you're going to play the pick four, the pick four begins off with race number 2. I would single this horse to here. But to recap my selection for the third from Zia, it's the Zia Park Distaff. Let's take the one horse cash check or charge. We'll go 1623 in the superfecta. Now, race number 5 from Zia, it is the Zia Park Sprint. It's going for a purse of $100,000, race for 3-year-olds and upwards. Right now, we have a field of 7 horses going to the main track, the distance of ground of 1,200 meters again, or the distance of ground of 6 furlongs on the main track. 1,200 meters, 6 furlongs. Top selection, we're going to go to the number 2 horse here, Chief Cicatraz. Cicatraz, hopefully I said that right, probably didn't, pardon. I'm going to go 2437 in the superfecta, 2437 super. Top selection, 2 horse, Chief Cicatraz. This 6-year-old gentleman by Munnings here, Sean Davis trains. Tyler Bays comes in from Southern California to ride the horse. The horse is most recent outing, 9th of November at Turf Paradise, 6 furlongs in Lou Krybosch Memorial, and he won by 1¾ lengths there. He stalked early on, he got the lead, 10 cents to the dollar, and 107.3 for the final 6 furlongs. That was an impressive run there, earning himself a 90 buyer. Before then, the Pat O'Brien at Del Mar, 7 furlongs August 24th. He finished 6th by 16¾ lengths. He lost to Catalina Cruz. He's a good horse who actually ran a crap race, I want to say, in the Breeders' Cup after that. But this horse, he stalked early on, dueled a little bit, but then just couldn't keep up with the better horses there. And then the Bing Crosby at Del Mar, he finished 7th by 9 lengths. Again, couldn't keep up there. You know, his last start on the B circuit, shall we say, came at Canterbury, 6.5 furlongs in the dark, in a 50,000 black type stakes. He won by 2¾ lengths. Again, he stalked, he got the lead, and then he took off clear. It was a very good run. He can't keep up with those great Southern California horses, but he can run against those horses on the lower level. Like I said, he's run his 2 best races in the last year on this lower level at Turf Paradise, making his 4th start here at Zia. And guess what? He's 3-for-3 on the surface also, but he hasn't run here in quite a while. But, he's been training well. He's a speedy horse. Another horse, a logical single in the pick four, which ends with this race here. The mid-card double is the second half of it, so this is another logical single. So 9-5, let's take him. So to recap my selection for the 5th from Zia, it's Zia Park Sprint. Let's take the 2 horse. We'll go 2437 in the superfecta. To race number 6 now from Zia, which is the Zia Park Juvenile. It's going for a purse $75,000, race for 2-year-olds here. We have a field of 7 horses again going to the main track, the distance of ground of 1,200 meters, or 6 furlongs on that main track. 1,200 meters, 6 furlongs. Top selection. We're gonna go to the number seven horse here. Mayas, whatever the horse's name is. We'll go 7-4-1-2 in the superfecta. 7-4-1-2 super. Top selection seven horse Mayas. This 2-year-old gelding by Rocky Barr. Francisco Arrieta gets leg up. The horse's most recent outing came in the Arizona Stales Futurity Race. They have a turf paradise for almost November the 2nd. First off, a little bit refreshing. He finished second by 3/4 in length. He sat back early, had to leave for a split portion, but then he got caught before the wire. 80 cents a dollar. He probably needed the race since it was first off a little bit of refreshing. Before then, the Gold Rush Futurity at Arapaho. Sloppy still going 6 furlongs on August the 11th. The horse won by a length that day. 2-1, this Colorado bred. He was drawn a little bit wide, with Lynn was a little bit wide, but he closed up well. It was an all-around good effort there. And then a state bred stakes race at Arapaho, 6 furlongs July 20th. He won by a half length. He stalked, he got the lead, and then he took off clear. Very good run, but it was against the little subpar horses. One thing I did notice about Arapaho, they're not in HD at the moment, and when you're used to watching the races on, you know, from Naira, from Del Mar, Gulfstream, those races are in crystal clear HD. When you go to Arapaho and watch those replays, it looks like somebody shot those races with a potato, I have to say, with the quality. But like I said, he ran very well in his last race at Arapaho. Last time I'd probably need the race. Here I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt that he needed the race last time out. I'll take him second off the break, 6-1, training well. Let's take him. So to recap my selection for the 6 from Zia Park Juvenile, let's take the 7 horse Mayas. I'm going to go 7-4-1-2 in the superfecta. Race number 7 now from Zia. It is the Zia Park Princess. It's going for a purse of $75,000. Race for 2-year-old fillies here. Field of 9 horses, again, going the distance of ground of 1,200 meters or the distance of ground of 6 furlongs on the main track. 1,200 meters, 6 furlongs here. Top selection, we'll go to the inside to the 2-horse G. She Sparkles. I'm gonna go 2683 in the superfecta, 2683 super. Top selection, 2-horse G. She Sparkles, cheerfully by race day. Danny Pish trains Danny Sorensen, gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came the 14th of July, Lone Star. 5.5 furlongs in a Texas Futurity. He won by 5.25 lengths there, and he set off a bit of a quick pace that day, but he closed up well late, got the lead. It was an all-around good effort there. Before the main specialweight, 22,000 for State Bred's Lone Star, 5 furlongs June the 15th. He won by 10.5 lengths, and again, he hit 3 of the rivals, and he was just much the best. A little bit wide in a very small field. I don't know why he went that wide, but he still got the job done late. You know, he's coming here off a break, but his workout patterns over Tama have been very nicely done. You know, let's give him a shot here. Looking over the other horses, I just don't see a lot of in there. You know, the horse that probably would have been my top selection would have been, it's probably scratched 7 horse with Zombie Girl, because she's done everything right. But with her out of here, it's become a little bit of a trickier race. So if you're going to play the multi race, I think your, you know, G. She Sparkles is your logical winner. If for a little insurance play, maybe the 6 horse Smart and Wicked at 15-1 could get a piece, but she's coming out to some, you know, okay races in, you know, at Albuquerque and Turf Paradise. 15-1, we'll use her a little bit as insurance on the pick 4, but I'm more, like I said, confident in the top selection. But to recap my selection for the 7th from Zia, it is the Zia Park Princess. Let's take the 2 horse G. She Sparkles. We'll use the 6 horse Smart and Wicked in the multi. We'll go 2683 in the superfecta. Now, race number 8 from Zia, it is the Zia Park Oaks. It's going for a purse of $250,000. Race for 3-year-old fillies. Field of 6 horses entered, but I think we're going to be down to a field of 4 horses here. I know most definitely Motion to Motion is scratched, and if I'm not mistaken, Lady Apple will be scratched. We'll be down to a field of 4 going the distance of ground of 1,700 meters or the mile and a 16th trip on the main track. 1,700 meters, a mile 16th. Top selection, we'll go to the number 5 horse here, Horologist, who's probably going to become your favorite here. I'll go 5-2 in the exacta. 5-2 exacta. Use both those in the multi, but the top selection is 5 horse Horologist. 3-year-old filly by Gemologist. Richard Baltus trains. Tyler Bays gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came 19th of October at Keeneland. 7 furlongs in the Grade 2 Raven Run. The horse finished 9th by 12.5 lengths and just had nothing that day. Never showed up. It just wasn't the day to win. Coming here to a mile 16th on a speed favoring race course, I think the horse can get a better trip here, and I think she'll, you know, with the step down class, she'll run a good race. Before then, the grade 1 Cotillion at Parks, mile 16th, 10th of the 21st. The horse finished 3rd by 6 lengths there, and again, just really couldn't keep up with those better horses, and, you know, it just wasn't the day to win. And then before then, the Monmouth Oaks at Monmouth, mile 16th, August 17th. The horse won by 3/4 length and upset a jaywalk that day. Me included, along with the rest of the betting world, thought jaywalk was just going to walk home, but this horse, you know, just had other thoughts and stalked, and she got a lead, and then she just took off clear. That was a very good run there. And then the Smart and Classy at Monmouth Mile for state bred, Jersey bred, she won by 1 3/4 lengths again on the free lead all throughout. It was just an all around good, easy victory. She's making the Zia Park debut today. Shouldn't be a problem. She's been training well at Santa Anita, 5-1. Like I said, you won't get 5-1 at post time. She'll be your favorite at post time, but she's a very likely winner. So let's take her. So to recap my selection for the 8th from Zia, it's Zia Park Oaks. Let's take the 5 horse Horologist. We'll go 5-2 in the exacta. Race number 9 now from Zia. It's probably one of the most wide open races of the afternoon. The 9th race, it's the Zia Park Championship Handicaps, going for a purse of $150,000 race for 3-year-olds and upwards. We have a field of 11 horses going to the main track, the distance of ground of 1,800 meters, or the distance of ground of 1 1/8 miles on the Zia main track. 1,800 meters, 1 1/8 miles. Top selection here. We're going to go to the number 3 horse, Clear the Mind. We'll go 3-7-11-8 in the superfecta. 3-7-11-8 super. Top selection of 3 horse, Clear the Mind. This 6-year-old girl in my Mineshaft here, who, going back through the years, Mineshaft, I believe he was horse year in 2002 or 2003, and he always gets overshadowed by the other horses of that era, but he was a very, you know, underrated horse, very good one, and, you know, he's produced some decent offspring. Not great, great, but, you know, some decent ones. But Enrique Gomez is on this one. His most recent outing came the 12th of November at Zia, mile 17, ops 30 claimer. He finished 3rd by 4.5 lengths that day, and he just, you know, set the pace early on. He couldn't get the good turn of foot, but, you know, he improved off the race before, which came in the Veterans Handicap at Zia, mile 16th, October the 28th. He finished 6th by 9 lengths that day, and he just had nothing, never quickened up, and it just was a weird run. He shouldn't improve a lot more there. And then at Zia, when Mom launched 45, finished 2nd by half length. He sat back early, it was very wide, but he was closing up late. If the race was, say, mile 70, he probably would have gone there. But he, like I said, he ran well there. And then at Albuquerque, 7 furlongs, ops 25, finished 2nd by 2 1/4 lengths. The winner, Libertarian, ran a major race on the front end. But this horse, he just stalked, and he was good there, but not, you know, great. He's come to the mile 8th for the first time. He's versatile. He could sit behind, or he could set the pace. I like the low post draw, you know, and hopefully he could, you know, not set the pace, but come from a stalking position. 15-1, I like him a lot, so let's take him. You know, looking over the multi-race here, I think you have to use the 7 horse there, and you have to use Sky Promise, and I would also use Safney. Like I said, all these horses are a bit of a long shot here, and they deserve to be because, well, not deserve to be, but, you know, like I said, this is a very wide open race, so it wouldn't surprise me if a 50-1 shot comes in here. The horse I don't like, actually, is the favorite here, the 5 horse. He's coming from Southern California, and I just can't get behind this horse because his dirt numbers have been very subpar. If the race is on the turf, she would win my single, but I'm not using the 5 horse. Like I said, I think he would catch price in this one, so you better do it. So to recount my selection for the 9th from Zia, Zia Park Championship Handicap, let's take the 3 horse, Clear the Mind. We'll go 3-7-11-8 in the superfecta, and we'll use all 4 of those digits in the pick 4. So now let's get to the finale, race number 10 from Zia. It's actually the feature race of the program. It's a Zia Park Derby, purse $250,000, race for 3-year-olds here. Field of 10 horses going the distance of ground of 1,700 meters, or the distance of ground of 1 1/16 miles on the main track. 1,700 meters, 1 1/16 miles main track. Top selection in the Derby, I'm going to go with the number 10 horse here, who is Mr. Moneybags. I'll go 10-1-3 in the trifecta. 10-1-3 trifecta. Top selection of 10 horse, Mr. Moneybags. This 3-year-old gelding by Silver City. Ernesto Jimenez is on this one. The horse's most recent out came at Zia, 28th of October, 6 furlongs in the Roadrunner Stakes. First off the break, the horse won by a nose, and he stalked, he got the lead, and then he just took off clear. Probably not the trip of ground he wanted. He wants to probably go a mile. last 16th like you're going to see today. And I think second off the break, he's going to improve a lot. Before then, the Iowa Derby at Prairie Meadow, mile 16th, July the 5th, he finished 6th by 6 lengths. He was drawn wide that day. He stalked, but just never had a good turn of foot. It wasn't his day to win. And then the Texas Stallion Stakes Lone Star 1 mile, he won by 11 3/4 lengths that day. Five other rivals, he sat on the front end all throughout and could have won around another three times and still won that easily. A very good run. It was an improvement off the race before, which came the Pat Day Mile Churchill. He stalked the lead, set the pace early on, but then he kind of hit the wall, and also he broke rein. What can you do there? But, you know, it just wasn't his day to win. But before that, over the winter, he was running well in the at Sam Houston, destroying all those fields. I like him at the mile 16 trip. You know, he's drawn a little bit wide, but I think he can win. 8-1, his price with the scratches will probably lower, but I like him a lot, so let's take him. So to recap my selection for the 10th from Zia, it's the Zia Park Derby. Let's take the 10-horse Mr. Moneybags. We'll go 10-1-3 in the trifecta. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at Horse Racing Kid 5. Good luck, everybody.